John, to what extent, if I gave you, you know, the KU birds database and you hadn't seen it before, to what extent do you do this sort of mapping record by record, like we just did, versus kind of field by field mapping for the whole database?
The answer for me personally is that I look at the whole database. I'll look at the database as a spreadsheet, let's say, every column right there at the top. And I'll sort of scan down until I'm convinced, looking at the values of the data, that I understand what it means. It could be, I could misconstrue what things mean in certain cases, and that's when I will ask. And it could be that there's so much diversity in a particular column that I need to look at all of it to know how I should deal with it. In that case, I'll actually do another step, which is I'll look at all the distinct values in a field. Like in this one, we have the VM. Right there. If I just saw SpecMat and VM, which is one record, I wouldn't have known what that was. But I looked through the whole database, I looked at all the values for SpecMat in LACM birds, and I saw an SK, and I saw the whole word wing spelled out, and I'm like, oh, okay, these are parts of birds. Then I tried to figure out what VM meant. I looked at a list of standard values for bird preparation. When the whole body map is on there. So I knew it was in the right direction.
So you're not going to do this 180,000 times individually for the LA County Museum collection. You're going to do it in as big chunks as you can and still see consistency within a field.
I'm going to do it field by field and then look into the data when I have it.
Small point of correction from the previous one to the beginning. This is not correct, we need to compare it with the key data.
Which is not correct?
This one is just this one. My unit is not correct. It's going to be the same around the same place. It's not encouraging.
So, what he's saying, by experience, is that Karimcho cannot be in the Rift Valley province. Is that right?
No, I'm saying when he was in the museum.
He has even more specific information, and that is that the, can you switch to the other one? That the locality, the Meningi Garson Road is not within Caricho.
It's not in
Caricho. Is it possible that 25 miles north of that road is in Caricho?
No.
Nor in here.
Is that road 25 miles north of a place name called Caricho?
Because mine is in the north province, and another is in
the Caricho. Completely separate places. Okay, so this is a good question. We would actually not have ever uncovered that problem in the data mapping exercise. Because what we're trying to figure out is what do the fields mean, not whether the values are correct, which is a separate step. And that's where our data cleaning, data assessment are going to come in. And we start to try to map those things. And we figure out, wait a minute, there's internal inconsistency in the geography of it. And we're unable to georeference it at that point. So, in terms of process of data publishing, data cleaning, what you've uncovered there is perfectly legitimate and will be revealed in a later step. Yep. Good point. Yeah. Start with small letters, and when do you have to start with big letters? the way that they're written here by Kyle was true to the actual field name of common core, which has a very simple rule. That is, that it always begins with a lowercase. That's to signify that it is called as a property, as opposed to a class. If you look at Darwin Core, standard, look at some of these fields, you'll see that every one of them begins with a lowercase letter, all of these, because they're all properties, or attributes, or field names. And that the ones that are categories like location, geological context, identification, they all have capital letters. It's because these are not fields in Darwin Core. They're just groups of fields. Okay, so the simple rule is every Darwin Core field begins with a lowercase, and wherever there's a word break, like higher geography, you capitalize the first letter of the word it breaks. So we have basis of record. It should be small b, big O, big R, basis of record. That's the rule. That's the rule for the name of the field in Darwin Core. Now, you can have different labels for these fields. Darwin Core doesn't specify what the label should be. But those who have done translations of the Darwin Core standards into other languages can make suggestions about how to label these for better understanding. And those are in legal words in the native language, separated by spaces. And it's not part of the standard. Okay, one thing then, I would urge you, if what we have just done seems like magic, and you don't have a good grasp, or you don't feel confident that you could do the same, then I suggest that you try to do the same with the other sheet in the spreadsheet. The idea is to make a copy of that spreadsheet or to download it as an Excel spreadsheet onto your own machine and then do the mapping and satisfy yourself that you understand how that works. If you have any questions or if you want me to review the mappings that you made, I'd be very happy to do so. I want to make sure that this critical part of the data publication process is understood.